Bambi is considered by many to be one of Walt Disney's crowning achievements. Although it opened in 1942, Walt began work on Bambi in 1936, while Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs were still in production. Over the course of those years, Walt and his hand-picked team met frequently to work out every detail of the film. These story meetings were captured in exact transcriptions as a guide for the filmmakers to refer back to during production. These transcriptions have lain dormant in the Walt Disney Studio archives for many years and have only recently been uncovered. Hello, I'm Patrick Stewart, and I'm here in the Walt Disney Studio archives to serve as your guide on a most unique journey. Imagine, if you will, that we're about to enter into a time machine and take a journey back to the late 1930s, early 1940s, to be flies on the wall at some of Walt Disney's story meetings for Bambi. Through dramatic reenactments, we'll bring to life some of these fascinating conversations between Walt and his creative team as they developed the story, characters, music, and artistic direction for this memorable film. As you watch, I believe you will be struck, as I was, by how closely the final film realizes the early vision of that film as it was discussed by Walt Disney and his creative team. Let's start our journey with Walt himself, relating his own eloquent vision for the opening of Bambi. Why don't we open our story with this?
Say we open with the morning in the forest. Maybe it could be something sort of mysterious. You wouldn't reveal it. I like this atmosphere of the woods in the beginning, taking a little time here to get your audience in the mood. Mystery would help that. Mystery of what was going on. Now, this would be effective if you had a moving multiplane shot, wouldn't it?
Yes.
It's a beautiful scene. Now, that could be your opening pan, and you move right on from that.
Yep, that'll work.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
Yes. That'll work.
We should feel the forest rather than see it. I wonder if the way you can best feel nature is just to hint at enough reality and let the rest of it go. Leave it to your imagination. In other words, keep our general background style simple and not very graphic. We're driving for a certain balance. Nature is very important in this picture dramatically. It's part of our conflict. Our picture as a whole doesn't just give over to nature, but it weaves.
At the end of this pan, we ought to kind of build into a little lighter mood. We gradually come into a light patch somewhere. You could fly Old Owl over and up to a tree in the multiplane shot, and then make a direct cut and see him landing in the tree, which gives you a direct break for your sequence. Well, that's a swell way to lead out of the darkness of the forest by going up a little bit and getting a little light. And then you come to the Old Owl, and he's going to sleep. He wouldn't say anything, just a little yawn or something. And then we introduce the squirrel and the chipmunk. We introduce all the characters we want to in that morning. Once we introduce Bambi, everything should be more or less through his eyes. If we want to do anything with a character, we want to do it before he appears. And then when he appears, we want to stay with him and his contact with these things. Now, maybe the squirrel is there sleeping, and the chipmunk is inside the squirrel's tail. The little chipmunk takes that tail and pulls it around him, like pulling a big fur around him, you know?
I think the thing that you have here, too, that is so swell is that you really have fantasy. I feel the fantasy, and I feel that fantasy and poetry are one and the same thing. You know, it's fantasy. It's not just a lot of grotesque situations. There's a difference between the poetic and the bizarre.
We're piling up a lot of reference material to influence many animators in the action and the timing and the movement of real animals. We must capture the spirit of reality interpreted in fantasy.
And then, as a final thing here, the owl has finally got everything quiet, and he's going to go back to sleep when this noise breaks loose that it's here. It's happened, where they begin flying around and the whole woods begins to fuss and swarm.
Oh, yeah.
It's here. This one little bird can't even finish what she's saying. She's so excited. It's here.
What bothers